To close out this episode, I have a game I don't think I'd played in about 15 years, Yoshi's Story. This was one of many N64 games I got the first Christmas after I got the console. I started with the console and Super Mario 64 as an early birthday present, then Banjo-Kazooie for that birthday, and then a bunch of games for Christmas that we used to rent from our local video shop, this being one of them. I had played Yoshi's Island as a kid before this, but when we got our N64, the Super Nintendo was handed down to my uncle before we got it back, and so this became my main Yoshi game for a while. Well, that, and after we got the Super Nintendo back, our original Yoshi's Island was destroyed when an unexpected TV fell on it. But anyway, story. The Yoshis all live in happiness on Yoshi's Island, with said happiness powered by the Super Happy Tree. But Baby Bowser steals the tree, which makes every Yoshi on the island depressed. He also casts a spell that turns the island into a picture book. That part I don't get, it doesn't really mean anything for anyone. I don't think the art style needed an in-universe justification. Since the Yoshis have become too dependent on this plant to do anything, six newborns hatch and have to get it back for them. Also, I guess the purple and brown Yoshis are sterile since they appear in the opening but didn't hatch any playable children. In fact, the brown Yoshi never appears again past this cameo outside of re-releases. It got its place taken by the orange Yoshi. Before I start the game proper, I do the practice level in case I forgot anything. Last time playing was over half my life ago. Also, last time I played an N64 game on the Wii U's virtual console was 6 years ago, and I need to remind myself what buttons correspond to what. We have Yoshi's usual jump, flutter jump, and tongue, which can be aimed in 8 directions, and moved around during the attack. Coins are in this game, but they serve no real purpose other than the points. The hint and egg blocks return from Yoshi's Island, but are much bigger and animated now. The limit on eggs is still 6. The goal of each level is to eat 30 fruit. There are far more than 30 in a single level, so it's up to you to decide how you want to go about it. You can just blaze through the level grabbing everything and being done in no time, or you can take your time to explore the level to see what else it has to offer. We start with some carried by the Shy Guys, followed by some inside bubbles that have to be burst with eggs. Eggs can also be used to destroy rocks, showing that other things are also hidden in bubbles. This one contains a white Shy Guy who, if you finish the level with him, can be used to free a Yoshi you've lost, more on that later. While most enemies and food eaten will heal Yoshi, filling up the sunflower health bar in the corner, there are some foods they don't like, such as chili peppers. There are also the odd flower that can be eaten from to restore health as well. The ground pound is here too and can be used to break certain objects. Next thing is the heart fruits that render Yoshi invincible, give them infinite eggs, and power up the ground pound so that it bursts all bubbles on screen and turns Shy Guys into fruit. Yoshi can go into a sniffing mode that allows me to search out hidden items found through ground pounding certain areas on the floor. Sometimes it's fruit, sometimes it can create platforms that let me continue the level. Next, the game teaches me the melon race. I ground pound the tin to free 7 boxes of melons I have to carefully carry to the finish line. Move too fast in one direction and they'll tip over and you'll drop them all. Carry them to the finish and they all turn into melons, letting me finish the practice. So throughout all these levels, I won't be putting too much attention towards pointing out the fruit I eat, as fruit is everywhere. I'll be focusing on the exploration instead. Now I can truly start story mode, starting with page 1, beginning. I have 4 levels to start with and I'll be doing 4 playthroughs to cover all 4 levels on all 6 pages. I'll alternate playthroughs every level to cover all levels on a page at once. So we're starting with page 1, level 1, treasure hunt. I have a roulette for a lucky fruit which just determines which fruit will heal me more. I'm going to try and give all the Yoshis equal usage, so I'm starting with the standard green Yoshi. This stage has the same visual design as the practice. This game really did a great job adding a ton of character to the Shy Guys. We have their reactions if you eat the fruit they're carrying for one thing. A bit in, I reach the first crossroads, showing the game isn't entirely left to right on a flat surface. There is a bit of moving on a third axis, but admittedly it isn't much. Here I meet the first Miss Warp. There are 4 of these in every level, and waking more than one will allow me to bounce off their heads and warp to the next awake one. After her I meet probably one of the most remembered enemies exclusive to this game, the Pack Ederm. They'll move between the 2 rows to block your path, so you have to ground pound to knock them over and then jump over them before they get back up. Past that is the surprise ball, attach your tongue to a ball to be instantly flung above it, letting me climb up this wall. After dropping down the other end I hit a question block to trigger a melon race. I start with 7 melons and have to make it to the finish before this chain chomp on the top of the screen slowly eats through them all. The obstacles for this one are mainly bubbles and another Pack Ederm, but since it's the first one I make it to the end with plenty of time to spare and get all 7 melons. I get a heart fruit from eating so many and the second Miss Warp soon after. Next is the magic vase, which pressing down on top of will take me to the next screen. Poochie is here and I pound down the post he's chained to. I follow him down one of the forks and he takes me to this level's first special heart. While starting the game lets you choose between all four page 1 levels to start with, getting access to more than just the following page's first level requires collecting a heart. This of course means each level has 3 hearts, unlocking the next page's levels 2, 3 and 4 in order. While I don't need to collect them all in every playthrough, I'm gonna anyway just to show them off. Poochie takes me to the next path and takes the upper fork, and I found the second special heart already, requiring a high flutter jump. Following Poochie some more, I pass by the third Miss Warp on the lower path, and my first Power Bee, which fully refills my health when eaten. Poochie takes me to another question block that frees 5 moving coins. I miss one here, but collecting them all makes a melon appear. At the next fork, I go down to break open a block in the air for the final special heart. The last few fruits are nearby. If you collect all of a level's 30 melons, the heart in the back will be a melon instead. I won't be doing all melons as the game doesn't really keep track of it, and I get nothing for it. At the end of every level, we get a recap of the level while the Yoshis sing, and when me and my oldest younger brother played this as kids, we thought it was just the cutest fucking thing. Though now I've seen it pointed out that the singing sounds like the arsehole, it's even cuter. The page turns, but first I'm gonna do page 1, level 2, surprise! Exclamation point, exclamation point. Just pretend I haven't unlocked a 7th Yoshi yet as I choose the yellow Yoshi. If you've played Super Smash Bros. Melee or Ultimate, the Yoshi Story stage from that game takes many of its visuals from this level's look. This game has quite a few strange enemies that never appeared again, like the Fuzzy Wiggler. To defeat it, I have to jump on all of its segments separately to turn them purple. Next is a spider, which can't be defeated. It's always dangling from a web and I have to throw eggs at it to send it bouncing around and make it retreat for a bit so I can pass under it. There's a tree with many shy guys hiding inside that ground pounding in front of will send them all flying out. A bubble right after drops a switch that creates a sequence of cloud platforms I have to climb under a timer to find the level's first special heart. Further right is the first Miss Warp, and further some more is a pair of blocks hiding a bubble holding a magic vase. It leads to one of the melon balancing minigames. To make it easier, I skip past them at first and clear the screen of the one enemy in the way. This lets me easily get all 7 melons. It gets me a heart fruit, but I'm already at the end of the screen and I can't carry its effects over. It puts me a bit further into the level between a pair of spiders, and with a bubble giving me a new heart fruit. Moving further on, I find a second Miss Warp and the end of this screen with a sign pointing me to the next. Poochie's on this screen and in front of him is a box containing an airbag. They'll breathe air strong enough to push me back and are defeated by shooting the cross on their stomachs. Moving further on, a bubble creates a bloom buddy that I can get on top of and stretch it out to reach high places, getting me the second special heart. My next new enemy is a Shy Guy variant bouncing on a pogo stick. Ignoring all the fruit and keeping right, I find the third Miss Warp. I walk back to the second and run back through many of the spiders. By sniffing this one yellow pipe, I can see there's something hidden, and so I ground pound to make the last special heart appear. I then eat the last fruit. The first level is pretty basic just in case you don't want to do the practice level. This one has a bit more going on with more enemies and obstacles being added in. Now for page 1, level 3, Rail Lift. This one is marked red as completed already because I either forgot to record it or my capture software crashed and I went back after finishing my third playthrough to re-record. I'm choosing the light blue Yoshi and, once again, ignore that I have another one unlocked. This one seems to be going for a more tropical theme, with the waves sewn into the background and the trees now palm trees, along with the music. We have a few surprise balls and the first Shy Guy on stilts. These can't be eaten yet and have to be jumped on to knock them off. Following it is the first Miss Warp and the stretch of fruit bubbles and more stilt guys. The Teehee butterfly makes its first appearance. They're fine when eaten while pink and happy, but when they turn blue, eating them causes damage. After a few pits, a bubble releases a switch that creates a chain of surprise balls leading into the clouds where I can find the first special heart. I jump across the rest of the clouds to reach the top of this cliff and find the exit to the second screen. This screen is where the level's namesake is. Clouds are on rails that they'll travel along once I land on them. Some of them require hitting levers to change their routes. There are also these bouncy balls on rails that act as obstacles. Overall, since this is the introduction to them and we're still on the first page, it's simple and I ride over to the third screen. This one starts with another melon carrying challenge that is done easily enough, followed by the third Miss Warp and the fourth screen. We have another screen with rails and even fruit are dangling from ropes attached to the rails now. Right away is a special heart in a bubble surrounded by a bouncy ball. While the next lot of cloud lifts are over a bottomless pit, there is a switch in a bubble that puts a temporary cloud floor over it. I get on the one at the end and ride it up to the top where I can grab the final special heart and eat the 30th fruit. This level's fine. It was always the one I played least out of the first four as a kid though. It still looks quite a bit like the previous one, so I think they just blended together a bit. Finally, page 1, level 4, Tower Climb, where I go through as the dark blue Yoshi. This one looks nothing like the other levels of its page, so back then it was a favourite. This level's main gimmick are these propeller lifts that continually rise while I can also steer them left and right. This first screen is very simple, just getting you used to steering them around floors and walls with no enemies in sight, all while we get this relaxing music and visuals with the colour scheme. No wonder I liked it so much as a kid. After a while I reached the first Miss Warp. Running right from there will actually cause two melons to spawn on the opposite side of this wall to pick up later. At this point enemies start showing up as tiki butterflies appear. It gets me to the top of the tower where there is an umbrella I can grab to slow my descent as I jump off the opposite side. Bullet bills also show up on the way down, being fired in a straight line. Past them I can grab those two melons I spawned. From there I drop to the bottom and go through the door on the right. It leads to a room filled with a huge amount of surprise balls. Climbing to the top of this part just gets more fruit, but going right most of the way up leads to the second Miss Warp. There's more balls leading further up to a row of spikes I can cross to find a box with a magic vase inside. In here is a minigame for melons I balls up right away. I was supposed to jump over the starting line, so running through it ended it right away. So when I take the exit I climb the balls it spawns me below to find the first special heart at the top. I drop down, cross a gap and climb up that side to find the exit to a new screen. This one has many clouds across a large drop. The tulips on here I couldn't work out as a kid. They turn you into a giant egg and you have to launch said egg by moving the stick in the opposite direction you want to move. I hit the one at the right end and give it some gentle nudges to bounce my way up to this cloud with the second special heart above it. I return to the level I started on and at the end, flutter jump even further right to just barely reach the third Miss Warp and another door. This screen has clouds that fire gusts of wind that can propel me upwards. I get carried up and hang around at the left edge of the screen, eventually taking me to the third special heart on the way. At the top is a roof with the final Miss Warp and a vase back to the start of the stage. I then backtrack through the level grabbing any fruit I skipped to finish it. I still like this level. It's still easy but has enough variety to be challenging for someone of the actual intended audience. And now we move on to page 2, Cavern. We're starting with level 1, Bone Dragon Pit. Going with the red Yoshi for this one. Right away we get the nipper plants appearing after going down a slight slope. They'll also drop down from the sky as spores. The Bone Dragon is another enemy that only appears in this game, and he's one of the ones I always remembered. They'll spit large fireballs at me and while I can egg their faces, I can also get on their heads and ground pound them. Either way, 3 hits kill it and the first Miss Warp is behind it. Moving on, I meet Poochie again and ground pound in front of him to find the first special heart. This is followed by a second Bone Dragon who's even easier to defeat since he has a line of blocks leading me straight to his head. Then it's pretty straightforward with nothing much until the second Miss Warp. I then have to break through a wall of blocks to take on a third Bone Dragon. Yellow blocks are unbreakable by the way. After it we get a more familiar enemy with the game's first Lakitu. Spinies couldn't make it into this game and instead they throw huge boulders down at me. I knock it out of its cloud, get on top and ride it up to this hidden section with a magic vase. This one leads to an optional mini boss, a 3-headed Bone Dragon. Since each head takes 2 hits to kill, it takes a full 6 eggs without missing to bring it down. One other notable thing about Bone Dragons is that their voice is clearly just recycled voice clips of Bowser from Mario Kart 64. Killing it gets me 3 melons. Dropping down from the vase has me jumping over gaps containing spikes, not to be confused with the other Mario enemy named Spike who is also in this game but doesn't go by that name. It leads to a vase to the next screen. Here I drop down the first gap and start breaking blocks. Instead of moving right into an open area, I break some more going down. Continuing down and going right leads to a bubble that drops a switch that spawns a second special heart on the opposite side of the wall that I get in no time. I backtrack to the first lot of blocks I broke and go right, jumping across these moving platforms. At the top right centre I go through another tunnel and drop down a large gap to find the third Miss Warp and another magic vase. It leads to a melon carrying game but I forget to take out all the enemies ahead first, dropping them while trying to jump over a shy guy. I go back and drop further down to reach the bottom half of the screen where the final Miss Warp is. At the left end of this door I can climb some surprise balls to a box hiding another vase. Here I have to smash through a few blocks to reach another 3-headed Bone Dragon. Since there's a moving platform right in front of the heads, I can ground pound them all to death. Killing them grants me the level's final special heart. Back on the bottom floor and I can use this tulip to launch myself to a bubble containing a giant black spotted Yoshi egg. Completing the level with this following me will unlock that black Yoshi we've seen from later playthroughs. And that's it for this level. I just go around eating the many fruit I skipped before until I'm finished. This level isn't the most exciting, but I've always been fond of it just for how often I played it back in the day. I was also a huge fan of the Bone Dragon as a kid. And now for page 2 level 2, Blarg's Boiler. The last of the default 6 Yoshis, the pink one, gets to be used here. This one has me jumping over platforms and bridges over lava. We have lava bubbles jumping from the lava, and also the Blarg, with its third new design of the 90s after both Mario World games had it looking differently. This one is easy, just trying to jump scare me as opposed to jumping towards me like they did in previous games. New to this game is the Lava Ghost, which jumps sideways in an arc. After that is the first special heart underneath this bone. I have to stand on it to weigh it down to let me grab it. The first Miss Warp is right next to it. I've not mentioned them before despite appearing, but we also have Flying Shy Guys, which are completely different to Fly Guys, who are often seen carrying fruit. Moving on, here's an enemy whose existence I forget every single time it leaves the screen, the Puffer. It ends up getting itself killed when it knocks me on top of itself. The level goes on like this for a bit, walking over spine bridges and weighing down bones, until I reach the end where there's the second Miss Warp and a magic vase to the second screen. Here is jumping across a few more bones until I reach this ball in the lava that rolls based on the side I'm standing on. Once I reach the end and can get off, I find the third Miss Warp and just past it, the second special heart. I have to wait for the block to get bored and submerge before I can lob an egg at it. Jumping across more bones and rolling along another ball takes me to a pipe in the ceiling I can go through. It takes me outside to another melon carrying game. This time I remember to take out the enemies on the path first and it goes smoothly. That gets me to needing just one fruit. The magic vase at the end then drops me right in front of the last special heart, needing me to weigh down another bone. Then I just grab the first fruit I see. That involves me reaching the end of the level and finding the fourth Miss Warp before I start back at the beginning and find it. That's a fun level. I find volcano levels at the time can risk being a bit dull thanks to just mainly being brown and orange, but that purple background with the fossils in the back really added a lot of character. Now for the third level of this page, Jelly Pipe, where I'll finally be playing as the black Yoshi I unlocked. I'm sure this one is infamous mainly for the music, which is a dude rapping gibberish followed by just the word Yoshi. This level is filled with jelly, as the name implies. Blue jelly slowly sinks under Yoshi's weight. The first Miss Warp is just a few steps from the start. The next jelly has a ghost inside moving left and right that can be defeated with a ground pound or just simply getting above them and flattening them into the floor. Running to the end of this tunnel and dropping down another puts me on top of the red slime. To the right is a question block that just has the classic many coins one at a time from the mainline Mario games, but this one also ends with a melon. I then do a very bad job keeping the red jelly sunk because it keeps raising my head into these spikes. At this fork I go down and push this box to the end, letting me flutter jump off it to reach the first special heart. From there I jump to the top, run to the right and go down a huge drop. When I reach the bottom with the spiked floor, I go right and drop even further, going right again. If I push this box into this slime, it will then spit out a melon. To the right of this is a door I skip and past it the second Miss Warp. Going all the way right then lets me reach a magic vase. This puts me in a fight with a giant slug. It will crawl along the floor and walls and I have to hit it in the eyes. This is very easy with the black Yoshi since their eggs have a large explosion effect when they pop, meaning larger range. Another benefit of the black Yoshi is that it has a stronger stomach, meaning it can eat chili peppers and other enemies that would damage the default Yoshis and be healed from it. Killing the slug gets me my second special heart. I backtrack to the second Miss Warp and then warp back to the first. Returning to the large drop after I got the first heart, I fall off to the left to enter a second tunnel that lets me fall further to a door. I run up the slope to the left and get hit by a spiked fungi rolling down. At the fork I can see the last special heart on the opposite side of the wall. I go down and left to find Poochie. I ground pound where he is to create some platforms leading to that final special heart. I climb up to find a Boo with a chain of smaller Boos following behind. This chain also contains a melon. I keep going right, eating everything and finding the fourth Miss Warp as I climb up. From there it's just a bit of climbing until I find the last few fruits. It's nice that the cavern page has so many different interpretations of cavern instead of just being all dull grey and brown caves. I always liked the look of this level with the ripped up newspapers making up the background. I do find it a bit confusing to navigate though. And for the final page 2 level we have Torrential Maze. Dark blue Yoshi again since I haven't shown off unlocking the white Yoshi yet. This level uses the same visuals as the previous one does. I start by jumping across a series of gaps with holes regularly spewing water, some of the gaps having spikes. I go all the way right and climb some surprise balls to find a few propeller lifts. I float around eating fruit and go up the tunnel in the top left corner. Jumping to the right up here leads to the first special heart. There are these ghost strings that can either create platforms I can climb with, or block me depending on which two holes it decides to use. I climb them to find an exit to another screen. But I can't actually do anything from here so I go back, dropping down to where the propeller lifts were and going left. I find the first Miss Warp and then do a long climb up with some moving platforms, then surprise balls and then another propeller lift with little space due to having two spiked walls on either side of me. At the top I go down a slope and fight against the water as I go up at the fork. Continuing right and ignoring the box has me going onto the next screen again. It drops me on a ledge and I burst a bubble for a surprise ball so I can keep going along the top. But instead I go along the bottom where there are more surprise balls to spawn. I follow the water flow to the bottom and keep going right to find the fourth Miss Warp. Using the ghost strings above me lets me get this second special heart hidden in the ceiling. I go through the door next to the Miss Warp to be sent back to the first. I return to the screen above the first set of propeller lifts to find the ghosts are appearing now. These things are spitting out platforms that I ride to the top to find another door leading to the third Miss Warp. I then jump across all these gaps until I reach another door to enter. I break these blocks and then push the blocks behind them into the slime for another melon and then go left down another watery slope. I burst free some more surprise balls and take them to another bubble containing the final special heart. Going through the door at the bottom drops me off by the second Miss Warp. Pushing the box next to it down and breaking it open gets me the last two fruits. This level is fine, but it's probably my least favourite of the page 2 ones. The maze can be a bit annoying and it's the only one of the page that reuses another level's visuals. But now we're on to page 3, Summit, and I start with level 1, Cloud Cruising. For this it's back to the Green Yoshi. We're back to level 1 and 2's visuals, but this level is nothing like that one. This screen actually has very little horizontal space. I can jump on this tube snake thing to have it start going up into the air. As they reach the top of the screen, they'll keep going off unless I jump onto them again to make them change direction. Eventually, I reach some clouds and get off to find a pink snake that travels much more vertically than the green one. I keep going up and moving between three of them until I reach some more clouds with the first Miss Warp. Ignoring the signs pointing me right and going left takes me to a bubble containing the level's first special heart. Going right takes me to another green snake and I go right and down to find a magic vase. It leads to a screen with several flying shy guys, not fly guys, just reminding you again. We're carrying a lot of fruit, and less than 3 minutes into the level, I'm only 8 fruit away from hitting the goal. I go through the vase, which takes me to a new screen with the second Miss Warp. Before continuing right, I go up this pipe next to her to reach a new screen with Poochie. I pound one of the clouds for the second special heart before I get a load of bees trying to fly into me. I go back through the pipe and get moving right onto this dragon. It moves on its own, so I just wait and eat until I hit a floating switch that activates some clouds to another vase. In here is the third Miss Warp and another switch that makes more clouds. As I do this long ascent up the clouds and other platforms all while under a timer, there are more switches parachuting down that I can hit to extend the timer. It's a long climb, but at the top is the third and final special heart, along with more than enough melons to get 30. But the level doesn't end here. Page 3 is the midpoint of the game, so all of its levels end in a boss fight. In this case, it's Cloud N Candy, one of the easiest bosses in all of video games. I just have to keep licking her to eat her. And while she can damage me, eating a chunk of her heals me. As I keep eating, she slowly shrinks until she's gone completely. Easy boss aside, that was a fun one. Having so much vertical travel was a nice change, and I thought those dragons were the coolest thing as a kid. Imagine my surprise when, over a decade later, the design came back for Gobblegut in Mario Galaxy 2. Now for level 2, the Tall Tower with the Yellow Yoshi. This level is similar to 1-4, but both the foreground and background graphics are different. This level's big gimmick are the giant springs I can bounce off of, larger ones bouncing me higher the closer to the end I bounce from. So after a bit of climbing I can already see the first special heart. But first I drop down to the left to find the first Miss Warp, then back to the big spring near the heart so I can bounce around and grab it. The climb continues with just a bit of fruit until I reach the first peeper enemy of the game. They're pretty harmless. I then climb some more until I reach a magic vase to a new screen. But before I move on, seeing that pepper on the ground brought something back. At 6 years old, I didn't know what a chili pepper was, and looking at the shape of this one, I thought it was a high-heeled shoe. This still made sense to me back then because, of course, eating a shoe wouldn't be good for you. I move right and then drop down to the bottom left at first opportunity to find a bubble containing a huge white egg. So now when I finish this level, I'll have unlocked the white Yoshi. I climb back up and drop down to the right to find the second Miss Warp. Getting back up, I can ride on this leaf, controlling when it dips and floats back up. I ride two of them over to a bubble with another magic vase inside. It leads to another melon race where I have to ride the leaf. I'm not used to it and I mess up and drop in the pit. Dying gets the Yoshi you're playing as captured by Toadies and taken to Bowser's castle. The only way to regain them on this playthrough is to find a white shy guy to rescue them with. I reset the game instead as I also lost the white Yoshi egg and couldn't get it back. Next time I get it right and zoom to the end fast enough to get all 7 melons. The vase at the end drops me by another leaf. While riding this one I get the second special heart and go down another vase at the end. The screen it takes me to has the third Miss Warp and these giant spheres, some with the ravens from Yoshi's Island walking around them. They'll spin in place if I land on one side of them. I just keep using them to climb higher and higher up the tower, getting closer to 30 fruit. As I get near the top, I get spiked balls on chains dropping down from nowhere to hit me, followed by one swinging left to right. I eventually reach a giant spring I can use to bounce to the left where the final special heart is. Eating one more fruit gets me the 30 and takes me to the boss. This time the boss is Inviso. This ghost claims to be totally invisible, but that's not entirely true. You can see where he is as that part of the background will distort. So I just have to throw an egg at him. He himself has no real attacks, just trying to collide with me. Peepers will also fly in for me to refill my stock of eggs with. It just takes 3 egg shots to take him out. I always liked this level more than this page's first one. A lot of it is the visual reasons I liked 1-4, but also I found bouncing on large heights on those springs more fun than the tube snakes. But now for level 3, Poochie and Nippy, with the light blue Yoshi. It's all snowy, and the first Miss Warp is right behind where I start. We've got shy guys in the background throwing snowballs with a little earmuffs on, I love that. Obviously being in the background means I can't attack them. Next is a few wobbly platforms to jump across. Here we can see the full background and I really like it. I know I've said it before in all the videos, but I just love snowy nighttime levels in games. Halfway across this pit is a surprise ball hidden above leading to the first special heart. Back on land and I get 4 Fly Guys, not flying shy guys remember, in a row. Shooting all 4 with the same egg would get me a melon, but I balls it up and have to settle for this melon balancing game instead. This one has me avoiding snowballs and having to cross a moving platform, but I balls this one up too. Moving on, I find the second Miss Warp and get jumping over a pit. When I can go up or continue right, I keep going right until I find these 9 blocks. Breaking the middle one gets me the second special heart. Then it's back on land to find a magic vase. It drops me by the third Miss Warp and after going right a little bit, there's a fork with both paths leading to a vase. But Poochie is here so I take the one he's leading me towards. This screen sees the return of another Yoshi's Island enemy, the Goonies. These ones fly by while dropping bombs above me. There are 2 boxes here and pushing them together gets me 2 melons. There's another fork here and once again I take the one Poochie is at. There's a pit here and I very nearly die when a Tiki Butterfly knocks me onto the very edge of this platform and almost tilts me into the pit. I climb over the blocks to reach the other side and once again take the vase Poochie is at. On this screen I can push this box and jump off it to find hidden surprise balls in the sky. These just get me a couple more hidden melons. Then it's to the end and in another vase Poochie is at. At the start of his screen I jump on top of the Goonie and ride it to the right. I have to avoid other ones, but it eventually carries me to the level's final special heart. At the end of the screen is the final Miss Warp and a vase back to the beginning of the level. From there I run through the level eating whatever I skipped. When I reach the first fork I take the other vase instead. I find the last 3 fruit in here and also get the first appearance of the black shy guy. These disagree with the default Yoshi stomachs, so only the black and white ones can eat them without taking damage. This time the boss battle takes place on the wonky platforms above the pit. The boss is Cloudjin. While flying around he breathes fire and has spiked balls drop from the sky. His weak point is his belly button, taking just 3 hits to take out. I really like this level, and most of it is down to the visuals as I've already explained. It's just so cozy despite all the bombs being dropped on me. Time to finish off page 3 with level 4, Frustration. The white Yoshi gets used for the first time here. Once again the first Miss Warp is right where I start. The white Yoshi has all the same extra abilities that the black Yoshi has. This level also has the same visuals as the previous one and in this case, I do not mind at all. This level's big gimmick is the giant wooden wheel I have to get in and keep jumping against the side of to get it moving. During this I get several fruit, peepers and the first special heart in a bubble. Eventually I reach land and am next crossing another of these pits with the tilting platforms. At the end I have to break a block wall to keep going. I also get to redeem myself and knocking out all the fly guys at once. Going down the steps I find the second Miss Warp and set off a melon race. This race is done entirely in the wheel. It's a pretty easy one and I get all 7 melons. A bit more to the right and I move on to the next screen. There's a fork here and what the fuck is that? I've played this level several times in my life, including for this video, and I still forgot that thing exists. It's a centipede and I believe it's invincible. I just keep going and find a Bumpty, another Yoshi's Island returnee. There's a few of these trying to bump me into the pits I cross before I find the third Miss Warp. Past these blocks is a Huffin' Puffin, whose children I can steal to act as eggs that can bounce off surfaces. I break through the blocks and the bubble to get my second special heart. Since the Puffins bounce off surfaces and don't explode, this means I can collect them again and reuse them. I move a stretch to the right and bust open another bubble for the final special heart. The last few fruit I need are all very close by. This boss battle takes place in the page 2 sewers, with the boss being Don Bongo. He's a giant spike, the mainline Mario enemy, not the things from 2-1. He walks around while his weight makes debris fall from above. To damage him I have to hit his lips to make them swell. He also speeds up every time he gets hit. Like the last 2 bosses, 3 hits is all it takes to defeat him. I liked this level for a lot of the same reasons I liked Poochie and Nippy, but it's hard to tell which one I liked more. This one has the wheel and the puffins I can use for infinite recoiling ammo. Moving on to page 4, Jungle, and its first level, Jungle Hut. The red Yoshi returns to this one. The actual spike enemies appear on this stage, going by their Japanese name, Gabon. They do their usual spiked ball spitting. I start by moving left and going straight to a new screen. At least one of the huts the level is named for. First, I go out of the other end to wake the second Miss Warp. The hut is filled with shy guys on stilts, and I mainly ignore them as I empty the hut for its fruit. Once I've cleared it out, I exit the screen in the bottom right. More stilt guys, but these platforms are small, so I can just nudge them off the edge. I drop to the bottom and break a block so I can reach this pipe and go down it. It drops me outside another hut. This one contains beehives with bees that aren't actually that aggressive. They'll just form the shape of a hand and make me take an alternate way around if I try walking past. I get around and out the other side and then climb up to the roof to go through another pipe that puts me back on the previous screen and gets me the first special heart. Then right a bit takes me to another screen. It's a hut filled with spikes. On the side I entered, I go through the higher exit. At the start of this screen, I eat a tulip and launch myself straight up to find the second special heart. I then climb straight up to find the first Miss Warp. From here, I can start climbing a series of surprise balls while avoiding spiders. It takes a few attempts, but I make it to the end and reach this pipe. It takes me to another hut, also filled with spiders. At the top is a switch that spawns many melons around the hut on a timer. They leave me just 3 away from finishing the level, and as I leave on the other side, I find the fourth Miss Warp. I go down the pipe, and on the screen it puts me on, I can drop down below the floor and flutter to the final special heart. I then go left to another screen with a hut filled with chain chomps. It's here I get my last free fruit. This level is okay, but it's kind of complex and so much of it looks the same, so it can get a bit confusing. The second level of this page is Jungle Puddle. The pink Yoshi gets a go at this one. This is the first level seen so far to include a swimming mechanic. It might be the easiest to control swimming in any Mario game. You just swim in the direction you move the stick, that's it. It's like a faster frog suit from Super Mario Bros. 3, but permanent. One enemy seen in the water is the Mr. Eel, which gives health but not eggs when eaten. Not far in, a bubble will give me the first special heart on bursting. A bit to the right is the first Miss Warp. I next get in the water, avoiding these spiked fruits that grow and fall in from above. Travelling right some more, I find 3 boxes. To get 3 melons, I have to break the middle one and then push the other 2 together. Another journey right in the water and I'll be able to swim down to find the second special heart. A bit further is a second Miss Warp. Nothing else interesting happens until I reach the end of the screen and move on to the next. This screen has a large Cheep Cheep, known as a red blurp in this game. Like the boss bass in Super Mario Bros. 3, these can jump out of the water and eat you for an instant kill. So I stay high and keep moving right until I see some coins in the water signalling the pipe I can go through. It drops me into a cave where I can do a melon balancing game while climbing these blocks. I don't get very far, so I just climb to the vase and leave. Where it drops me, there's a blue blurp that spits water hard enough to push me around. The third Miss Warp is here too. I keep heading right until it leaves me alone, but that gets another red one on me again. At one point I can do a floor jump off a ledge and just barely reach the third and final special heart. I just keep running to the left then and find the vase that takes me back to the beginning, with the fourth Miss Warp next to it. I then repeat the level while eating whatever I skipped until I hit 30. Not that bothered about this level, its visuals didn't do much for me and gameplay wise I didn't find it too interesting. The third level of the page is Piranha Grove, which the Black Yoshi gets to take on. I gotta say, I didn't remember anything from this level before replaying it. But this stage looks pretty cool, the background being filled with trees covered in thorny piranha plant vines. The first enemy I face here is the Piranha Pest, which flies around and has the same long tongue as Yoshi. If they catch you, they swallow you and spit you out tiny for a bit. I ride the moving platforms here up to some clouds with the first Miss Warp on them. This lets me get the eggs needed to take out the pests and continue to the right. A large piranha plant rises from the ground, but it takes a single egg to the head to bring down. There's a box I can keep pushing right, past a few more piranha plants until it makes contact with another box and they break for 2 melons. Right some more has me move to the next screen. After crossing a few platforms, I can ground pound this bit of floor to create more platforms going up some clouds with the first special heart on them. Dropping down to the right puts me by the second Miss Warp. What follows is a long chain of moving platforms slowly going up until I can go left or right. I take the right set of platforms, but it gets me juggled by a pest eating me and then spitting me straight up back into its mouth. With no health left, I just managed to floor jump to the next platform to find that it was pointless and the left platform before would have put me up here painlessly. This followed by even more platform climbing while trying to avoid being eaten by even more pests until I reach the top. But the bubble up here contains a second special heart and I have no eggs, so I have to drop all the way down to the nearest egg block and not get eaten on the way back up, as they take away all my eggs. After a couple attempts, I get up and can claim the heart. I then jump off the top to the left, following the coins until I land at a magic vase. This screen starts out with the third Miss Warp. Next to that are another piranha plant variant, the Piranha Sprout. My next challenge is to take out a piranha plant without rolling into the pit with this ball. Going right some more and I eventually reach another ball over some thorns. I roll it down most of the way but accidentally lose it when I send it the wrong way off the edge. But I'm close enough to the end that I can floor jump to the next magic vase. This one has another melon balance game and I first take out the piranha sprouts in the path before I start and I get all 7 melons. I have to leave too though, since I haven't found the last special heart yet. The next vase drops me by more balls on vines, and on this path is the final heart, being guarded by a piranha plant. I get the heart and eat a nearby fruit I skipped. The piranha pests were a pain, but I quite enjoyed this level. It's the most challenging one so far, and visually it's my favourite of the page. That just leaves level 4 of this page, Neuron Jungle, starring the white Yoshi. The first screen has just a hint block and a magic vase. This level has the most cases of what the fuck is that, starting with the neurons themselves and floating down from the sky, the ick worm. It's not long before I'm finding the first special heart, requiring me to squash down a neuron with a ground pound. Some neurons don't move much, others flatten themselves on their own, and some move side to side erratically. High up is the first miss warp. I drop down a large distance to find a switch between two red neurons. I flatten one and press a switch so I can reach the three melons it spawns in time. Flattening the other one allows me to drop down and find the second special heart. Above that is the second miss warp, and to the right I'm platforming over a few moving neurons until I reach the end of the screen. The screen has water and Poochie. I jump past Poochie and flutter over a lot of it, flattening a frog doing so. That's really its name, just frog. I also end up swimming under these sea cacti that cause damage on contact. They also vary in size. I keep moving right, jumping over loads of them until a bubble gives me the final special heart of this level. From there I just keep running right, eating everything I can. This also involves getting in this tub and making it move in the direction of the side I'm standing in. It doesn't take long. This level is more memorable than the similar Jungle Puddle, mainly due to all the weird looking stuff in it, but overall I'd say the Jungle page is probably my least favourite of the six. But now we move on to page 5, Ocean, and its first level, lots of jellyfish, which the green Yoshi will get to take on. So we start off outside where I can pop a bubble for the first miss warp before going down this pipe. The majority of this level takes place underwater. We've got regular jellyfish that don't actively try to attack me, just move around. There's pink ones that have a bit more mobility but don't actually go for me specifically. I enter this small tunnel and in the bottom right is the first special heart. I then leave the way I came and go over the top instead. I go down the fourth turn and then left to reach the second special heart. There are these spiny cheat cheeps down here that I can't eat as well. I go right a bit and then all the way up to go through this red pipe. It leads outside where the second miss warp is. Back in the water I go through the tunnel on the right and in this cave all the way down and right to reach another pipe. It leads to another maze with regular cheap cheeps and the snorkel snake, which swims around to take up space and damage me with its spikes. I avoid it and work my way to the bottom right corner to go through another pipe. This screen has green stationary jellyfish and Shy Guys submarines that fire torpedoes. I make my way up and to the right until I enter a cave and take the first tunnel down, leading to the final special heart. Now I just keep going right and eat everything I see. Sea cacti also appear on this screen surrounding a few rocks, and past them is a large jellyfish maze. It doesn't take long for me to reach those 30 fruit. This was a short level, but I quite enjoyed it. I still believe this is the most fun swimming mechanics in a Mario game, and I'm actually disappointed there isn't more swimming for once. The second level of this page is lots of fish. The yellow Yoshi will be taking this one and it starts us underwater this time instead of on land. The cheap cheeps return and we get clams that open up to release bubbles that would propel me up with them. Sea cacti are here too. After the first tunnel I go straight up to enter a pipe. It takes me outside where the first miss warp is. By this wall is a spot I can ground pound to create some platforms to the top. It takes me to two boxes I can push together to get a pair of melons. Poochie will also point out another I can get with the ground pound. Back through the pipe and through a very straightforward set of tunnels until I reach a more open area. To the bottom right is another pipe I go through. It leads to a screen with several cheap cheeps, many of which are carrying melons as they swim by. So I get to fill in a good chunk of my fruit counter. Eating every single cheap cheep in this screen will make the first special heart appear. I go through the pipe and swim a long distance right until I can turn down to find another green pipe. It puts me in a cave with the third miss warp. Around the sign next to her I can ground pound to make a switch appear that spawns two more melons, just one away from finishing the level. I leave and to the left of the pipe is the second special heart. I then follow the screen right until I reach a pipe leading back outside. There's a melon game here but I fail it. To the right end of the screen is the fourth miss warp and just left of her a bubble with the final special heart. I then eat the last fruit. This level is fine too, but in terms of water levels the previous one was more memorable to me. This felt like it had less going on. Third level of the page is Shy Guy Limbo. The light blue Yoshi gets this one and this time we get a level with no water in it. I spot a Lakitu in the background and wait for it to come to my part of the screen so I can follow him. Between his spiked balls he'll drop the odd fruit. After a bit we get the limboing Shy Guys the level's title promised. I can't kill them but they're easy to avoid. After them I use surprise balls to climb a bit higher. But after jumping a big pit I find the second miss warp. By her I steal the Lakitu's cloud and ride it straight up to find a pipe. It leads to a new melon game. I have to get boosted into the air by this cloud and see how far I can float a jump, which number I make it past when I land is the number of melons I'll win. I don't even get one. Continuing on from the Miss Warp, I keep going right without much new, mainly more Pogo Shy Guys and Limboing ones. Near the end of the screen I hear a switch out of the air for the first special heart before I go through the vase at the end. This screen has many clouds and dewdrops falling from them. Eating them doesn't help me avoid them as they don't agree with the default Yoshi stomachs and cause damage. Past the clouds is the first Miss Warp, then more Limbo Shy Guys until I reach a Lakitu pouring water from its cloud. I take the cloud and ride it up and left to some more clouds for some hidden melons. Even further to the right is a huge mass of clouds with the second special heart just chilling in the middle. I backtrack a bit to these small platforms and ground pound one for the final heart before finishing off the level. This level was also fine, the Limbo Shy Guys were cute but there wasn't much else to make it stand out. To finish off page 5 we have Shy Guy Ship, which the dark blue Yoshi will take. The titular ship is in the background firing streams of bombs at me. After the first lot is the first Miss Warp. Moving right some more and getting a second lot of them, I get Stilt Guys and Surprise Balls to get over them with. That's all pretty easy, but after that things get a bit tougher. The majority of the floor is now made of breakable blocks, and since the ship fires three bombs at once, as they start exploding we lose ground pretty quickly. But first, the second block to the left of this pipe is hiding the first special heart. Past the blocks is the second Miss Warp. Then it's a bit with more stilts until I reach the next screen. Goonies return on this screen and the third Miss Warp isn't very far in. Bullet Bills and their blasters also appear on this level. I get past the first two and go down this pipe. On this screen, hitting the block starts a melon race and makes many surprise balls appear. Just have to jump and lick up very quickly, and make it to the top in time to get all 7 melons. From where the pipe lets me out, I climb up the right and try a long floor jump to try and land on the second special heart, but I just fail to make it so I have to settle for riding a Goonie to it. I go right some more to the next large pit requiring me to ride a Goonie over it. I break the block holding up the second middle blaster to reveal it was hiding the last special heart. I ride the Goonie to the end where the 4th Miss Warp is along with the vase back to the start. I then retrace my steps to fill out the last 3 fruit slots. I liked this more than the previous level, it was tougher and the pirate ship gimmick makes it fit the ocean world more without having to actually be in water. But now we're on to page 6, finale, and starting with its first level, Mecha Castle. The red Yoshi gets this one. Now this is a level I never forgot. Since it's the default choice, it was the level I finished the game through the most. To start with, I have to get on this pendulum and move the control stick in the direction it does to make it swing further, raising the barricade to the right. Once it's high enough, I can slip under. The next corridor has swords that shoot out from the floor and ceiling, though they do give you a small warning beforehand. I jump the gap onto these steps where standing on the bottom step spawns a melon. I climb up and take the surprise ball to the top left, leading to the first special heart and a red sword, which always moves along the metal rail in the ground that it's attached to. I drop down and get moving forward where there's a few more swords to avoid of both colours. Following the swords are the cogs and you can tell this is still my first playthrough in years as I slip right off the first one and die, so the green Yoshi has to take its place. Getting past the cogs and avoiding a sword in the wall gets me the first Miss Warp. I jump the gap to the left and climb up the platforms to find a switch in a bubble. It spawns some coins leading to the cogs and as I cross them, there's another I can hit to extend the timer. It creates these surprise balls after the cogs that I climb to a magic vase. This screen has the third Miss Warp and the black Shy Guys carrying these rocks covered in spikes with thump faces chiseled onto them. That last detail I only just noticed watching it back for this script. I have to get through this small tunnel with them above both exits and get hit by both on the way through. I get a heart fruit soon after though, which doesn't mean much as I somehow let myself fall into a pit and die again, so the yellow Yoshi has to finish the job. Next time I make it across and shoot the bubble at the end for the second special heart. The vase sends me to this new screen with this giant rotating log that's easy to get over. But the next one is in front of this instant killing crusher I have to time my way through. Over the next log I let myself fall through the bomb to reach the second Miss Warp. Right some more and the platform takes me up to the final special heart. Obviously I don't need to collect these anymore as there are no more new levels to unlock, but I may as well at this point. I have to get through 2 crushers at once and then drop down to get through 3. After this I get my final fruit. This was always the most memorable level of the page to me, with all these giant blades and crushers being surprisingly brutal compared to the rest of the game. Since the final boss is the same every time, I'm going to cover it once at the end, so next is the second level of the page, Lift Castle, starring the pink Yoshi. I start off in front of a locked door. To the right is a Shy Guy with a bootleg thwomp, to the right is a set of grinders returning from the first Super Mario World. It's here I actually need to use Yoshi's crouch walk for the first time. This is followed by a long climb upwards past a few grinder rails. At the top is a switch in the bubble creating a trail of coins leading me past several of those bouncy balls from much earlier. As I cross the pit, there's a second to extend the timer, and I get climbing up the surprise balls and it was just a melon on a cloud. I drop down and go through the door to the right. This room is filled with bouncy balls and I finally get to acknowledge the combat as I kill it, making it drop the key to that door. Back out of the door and to the right, I go through a pipe to a screen resembling 1-4. The second Miss Warp is here. I ignore the umbrella, jump off, and float to the left to grab the first special heart. I then just let myself drop to the bottom, past all the grinders and bounty balls, grabbing any fruit I can on the way. At the bottom is the first Miss Warp, and a pipe leading back to the start so I can use the key and go through the door. This room is entirely needed to get past several shy guys with their thwomps, including some that have the windy clouds blowing me back. At the end, I go through the next door. The start of the room has the third Miss Warp. At this first pair of bouncy balls, I get underneath one so it launches me up into the second special heart. This is followed by more balls and some clouds on rails, and then a balloon buddy that also moves along a rail, so I have to move its body to avoid colliding with grinders. I reach the end and go through the door with only one fruit remaining. I ignore the game in here and run up the slope to the top where I can burst a bubble for the last special heart. The fourth Miss Warp is up here too. I then just go back and eat the first fruit I can. This was also a pretty fun one, a nice final test of all the various movement-based obstacles we've seen throughout the game. The third level of this page is the Ghost Castle, which the Black Yoshi will get to play. This time it looks like we're in some cavern beneath the castle or something. This level starts with a blindfold boo. Instead of moving based on whether I'm looking at them or not, they chase me based on sound. I keep jumping the pit until I reach the first pipe, which I go into just to ground pound a melon from this spot and then leave. I keep moving to the end of the screen where the first Miss Warp is, and then go through the door. First thing I do in this room is run left and then go down another pipe. There's a key in here that I grab and then go back. In the previous room I climb up the left side and unlock the first door I see. This is a dark room with the fourth Miss Warp inside and a boo with a light attached to its head. I make my way through the shy guys with these spiked rocks and reach these spinning things I have to climb. Dealing with several of those leads me to a row of blocks with the shy guys above them, waiting to crush me. I break one and drop under to break the fourth one from the left, which contains the first special heart. Of course, since I'm a Yoshi that can eat black shy guys this time, this part is a bit easier to get through. Next comes the boo block, boos that turn into blocks when you look at them. Then comes moving down through several spinning things while also dealing with the shy guys with rocks again. Past them is a door that drops me into a cave. It drops me to the bottom where there's a pipe leading me back to the first screen. Back into the next room I climb all the way up to the left and go through the door there. The third Miss Warp is here. This room contains ghost riders, who float across the screen and can be used as platforms. There are also boo blocks here. It's a long climb to the top, which involves taking a detour to the right while close to the top for the second special heart, and my reward is a key before going through the door there, which puts me in the same cave leading back to the first screen. Back in the main room, I climb to the right and unlock the door there. This room has some very tiny boos. This time I have to manipulate the boo block so that I can cross the gaps and climb up to places too high to jump. Halfway through I can ground pound a yellow block for the third special heart. Following that is jumping across more boos to reach the end, which puts me in a new cave. Going all the way left and up a pipe puts me back in the main room, where I climb all the way up to the right where the second Miss Warp is and go through the door there. In here I eat the last two fruit. I always thought this one was a nightmare as a kid, but over 20 years later, it's still one of the tougher ones, but pretty fun with all the boo block stuff to mess about with. This just leaves the final level, Magma Castle, which the White Yoshi will get. I died a couple times and reset to keep the White Yoshi, as I'd need to go unlock it again otherwise, but let's skip those failures. First I go left into a door to wake the first Miss Warp, and then go back out to get a ride on a dragon, a red version of the one in Cloud Cruising. But this one is much less safe, as its constant dips have it going into the magma, leaving me several gaps I have to jump to avoid instant death. It's a long ride and fills almost a quarter of my fruit counter before I go through a door at the end to the next screen. I get the second Miss Warp before I have to jump across moving platforms while avoiding magma pouring from the pipes. This is followed by a climb up some slopes, some of which have more magma being poured down them. At the fork, I go left and keep climbing until I can break through a few blocks to reach the first special heart. I keep climbing up and things get trickier as I'm having to avoid several streams of magma all close to each other at once. At my next fork, I go right and drop down to another floor. The slug from Jellypipe returns, but this time I have to take out two, requiring perfect aim with all six eggs. Killing them both gets me a key. Back outside, I launch myself back up that drop using a tulip. This is so I can refill my eggs, and I drop back down to launch myself up the other side, where I then go right onto another screen. The level has one last what the fuck is that enemy with the attacky sack, just big and bouncing around and in spaces too small for them. Getting past them and climbing up to a room filled with boxes, I ignore them and get climbing some more through the top left. I then go right, crouch walking under some spikes to reach the second special heart. The box next to it has the third Miss Warp, which I use to return to the first so that I can unlock the door to the left of her. This room has four combats that when killed grant me the game's final special heart. I return to the second Miss Warp and retrace my steps, eating all the fruit I skipped. For such an intentionally easy game, this final level is suitably challenging, definitely the game's hardest. But now we have to face the final boss, Baby Bowser, holding the Super Happy Tree hostage, demanding Yoshi be his pet instead of Mario's. He also gives away how to damage him. He jumps up and starts riding these ghosts around while bob-ombs fall from the air. This is easy since I have a tree with infinitely respawning fruit to heal with. I have to throw either the bob-ombs or the heart fruit powered eggs at the spikes on the ceiling to make them fall and collide with Baby Bowser. Powered up egg explosions can also harm him, as my third hit defeats the first phase. He's not very happy with his beating and resorts to trying to crush me with ground pounds. At this point, just explosions from the still falling bob-ombs can damage him, whether thrown at him or he just happens to be next to one as it naturally goes off. All it takes is another 3 more hits to finish him. Bowser throws a little tantrum now he's lost and lets the Yoshis have the tree back, saying he didn't even like it anyway. The Tories then fly in and carry a crying Baby Bowser out of the castle. And for the ending, we get to see Yoshi's story in book form open up as we go through all the recaps of the levels we played in that particular run, adding in one for the castle we just beat. Yoshi's Island is returned to normal and we get to see all the Yoshis jumping for joy around the Super Happy Tree as the book closes. Checking out trial mode after this shows that I have now unlocked every level for free play now that I finished them all in story mode. And there's Yoshi's story. This game got a lot of shit from older players back then, whether for being too easy, too childish, or not much of a sequel to Yoshi's Island. But as someone who had both played Yoshi's Island and was the actual target audience when I first played it at 6 years old, none of these things bother me, even today. Considering the game's final title is not Yoshi's Island 2 or anything, I was never even comparing it to that game. But as for the difficulty, of course today I pretty much blitzed through it as a then 29 year old with several years experience. At 6, this was still a tough game for me. Coming back to it after so long, I still like it quite a lot. The arts and crafts art style, the general cuteness of it all, and a soundtrack that I found very relaxing to come back to. Going through the game was a fun, chill experience. I wouldn't call it the best Yoshi game or anything, but very good and accomplishes what it was actually aiming for the audience it was aiming for. Probably in the top 10% or so of N64 games, though obviously I far from played them all, but it's definitely going to crack the current top 20 in the ranking.